they're fairly comprehensible. Sometimes you get very, difficult labels.
Yeah.
So one of the first things that we sometimes do when we get people to sort cards is say, can you sort them into two piles? Those that you understand and those that you don't, where you've got a question mark.
Yeah.
And you ask the people, when you're looking at a label, have you got a good...
Probably we need to some sort of
and then getting around inside.
Getting around.
And then we have things to do.
Tourist information.
And then useful information.
So,
and then you had tourists.
If you figure out that your target audience or your users are using particular search criteria, pull them out from advanced search, put them up front in single search or in the first search. Don't wait for users to get to the advanced search and fill it up. If you think keywords work in your site, let it be keywords. But use a simple search before users jump on to the advanced search.
The other way of
what are your three takeaways from the workshop?
See, three takes are, one is how to do usability testing particularly was informative. Homepage design tips was good. And over and above that, some brief feedback that we received on what customers look for, how are they interacting with the website.
Three top takeaways that I have had from this is, one, if I'm not mistaken, I'm just trying to go by the priorities, is the information that needs to come onto the header and how large and bold it should be, how visible it should be, what is your core communication in terms of the messaging that needs to come up there. The second important thing was the squint eye test, which I found was that we never knew about. And this is a very important thought that came to our mind that, you know, we should have done this in terms of looking at how squint can I get when I look for information. And last but not the least, I would feel the navigation area as to how easy is it to maneuver
because I'm not a testing, I'm not a tech guy. I think the minimum amount of stuff is one thing that I would recommend is that there's no process of question and answer. Because questions and answers are side by side. You should get done with the content first and then open it up for questions. Otherwise, it becomes more of a group discussion. And you know, everyone has a viewpoint, everyone wants to butt in and say, this is what I think, this is what happened in my business. That deviates away from the context. It is all of us.